May the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be always pleasing in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. So there's a set of fairly well-known drug trials where what happened in the 60s, I'm told, I wasn't there. It became very popular with a certain section of society. And some people thought that was a bad idea. And some people thought it was a fantastic idea. A scientist did a study where he provided rats in a cage with two things of water. One was laced with drugs, one was pure water. And he noted that over time, the rats would continue to return to the water that had the drug in it until eventually they would overdose and die. And this became a really strong motive for a lot of people to say drugs are a bad idea. This and a whole lot of other things. As it would point to the idea that people will keep taking drugs until it'll literally destroy them. However, what didn't change is people's desire to take drugs. So people know about the study and they just went, yep, I'm fine with that study, and then they would go and take drugs, whatever drugs they took. First story. Second, there is a quote which is attributed to a number of people, not least Mother Teresa, that the greatest disease that modern society faces is loneliness. Paraphrasing possibly. So, what do those two things have to say to St. Francis? Because today we remember St. Francis, who's usually sort of associated with birds and preaching to the animals and those sorts of things. I think St. Francis has a lot to say to us. Because he had a very mystical and spiritual understanding of the world. You see, one of the things that happens to people that take certain classes of drugs also happens biochemically in the brain to people who have religious and mystical experiences. And that is that their sense of boundaries break down. Their understanding of the distinctiveness between them and the other starts to erode. I suspect that a lot of people take the drugs because what they are looking for is an escape from the loneliness, an escape from the isolation. They want that experience of something in the desert of their own lives. Borne out by a follow-up experiment on the rats, by the way. Another scientist many years later came along and looked at the experiment with the rats and went, you know what, those rats live in a very boring box. What I'm going to do is I'm going to give them a nice box with like one of the wheels and pretty colored toys and other rats to play with, and I'll give them the water that's boring and the water that's got the drugs in it. And he found that although sometimes the rats went and had the water with the drugs in it, sometimes they just went to the normal water. And they played on the hamster wheel. And they chatted to other rats. I don't know. There's something to be said for recognizing that although people may choose to take drugs, a lot of them, their experience is driven by the experience of loneliness and isolation and seeking connection and escape from their own lives. So the first thing to recognize is that if we as a society can put in place those other things, then the scourge of drugs will probably quite naturally be reduced to a certain extent. And one of the things that we can foster was something that Francis fostered. He's famous for speaking about the animals as his brothers and sisters. So not only were the other people who were with him his brothers and sisters, the orders, the monastic and the lay orders that he founded, they were his brothers and sisters. The sun, he referred to as brother, the sun, the moon, sister moon. Even death, sister, death. Francis had managed through prayer and spiritual experiences and through his own life to see the world in a way that wasn't defined by the boundaries, but rather by the connections. And so in that, in his prayer and spirituality, in his following of Christ, he points to a way to overcome that great disease that drives, I believe, many of the other social diseases of modern times. Francis is also remembered for the vows of poverty that he and his followers took. He annoyed his dad, who was a merchant, by occasionally selling stuff and then going and giving the money to the poor rather than back to dad. And I don't want to say that poverty is an inherently spiritual thing. It's not. Poor people are not inherently more spiritual than rich people. That's just not the case. However, people who have had the opportunity to have stuff and have recognized the hollowness in kind of an acquisitorial lifestyle. I don't know if I just made that word up, but anyway. You know, that desire to always have more, who recognize the hollowness of that because they see that it cuts themselves off from their brothers and sisters, many of whom are poor. That is a sign of spirituality and faithfulness. And understanding that the connections that are valuable, that are rich, that are worth fostering, are not the connections to stuff, but are the connections to our brothers and sisters. So as we remember Francis, and on Sunday we'll talk about Francis in connection to the environment and ecology, but as we remember Francis, I believe that if we can emulate Francis, we can work to reduce some of the social diseases of our world. He is a model of a better life. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Amen.